We want to divide these two numbers written in scientific notation without the use of a calculator. To do this, we can think of dividing this up into two different fractions connected by multiplication. So this is equivalent to 7 divided by 2 times 10 to the 12th divided by 10 to the 7th. So now we'll determine this quotient, and then we'll determine this quotient. Well, 7 divided by 2, the decimal point would be here. So there's 3 2's in 7. 3 times 2 is 6. We subtract, that would be 1. We're going to have to add extra zeros to the right of this decimal point. So let's go ahead and move this up into our quotient. Now we can bring this 0 down, and we have 10. And we can ask how many 2's there are in 10. That would be 5. 5 times 2 is 10. Find the difference here, which is 0, so we're done. So this quotient is equal to 3.5 times, now to determine the quotient here, since the bases are the same, we subtract our exponents. 12 minus 7 is equal to 5, so we have 10 to the power of 5. So this quotient is equal to 3.5 times 10 to the fifth. And notice how it isn't the correct form for scientific notation. Remember, this number here has to be greater than or equal to 1 and less than 10. Let's go ahead and take a look at one more example. We're going to start by doing the same thing. We'll divide this in half and write it as a product of two different fractions. So we'll have 2.4 divided by 4.8. This will be 10 to the 7th divided by 10 to the 2nd. So now we'll determine this quotient here and then this quotient here. We should recognize this as 1 half or 0.5. Let's go ahead and just verify it. We have 2.4 divided by 4.8. So we'd move the decimal point to the right once here and then to the right once here. And then move the decimal point straight up. And right away we're going to have to add a 0 here so we can determine how many 48s are on 240. That happens to be 5. 5 times 48 is 240, so this difference is 0. So this quotient is 0.5, or 0.5, times, and then this quotient here, since we're dividing, we subtract our exponents, and 7 minus 2 is equal to 5, so this is 10 to the fifth. So while this is the quotient, we need to recognize that the significand or mantissa here is not in the correct form. This number here has to be greater than or equal to 1 and less than 10, so it's too small. So what we'll do is write 0.5 in scientific notation and then multiply it by 10 to the fifth. So here we have to move the decimal to the right one place, giving us 5 times 10 to the negative 1, and then we have to multiply this by 10 to the fifth. So our final answer is going to be 5 times 10 to the negative 1 plus 5 would be positive 4. So we have 5 times 10 to the 4th as our quotient in the correct form for scientific notation. So sometimes when we divide, we have this extra step where the significand or mantissa is not in the correct form for scientific notation.